Today's class is entitled Apocalypse 20? Question mark, question mark. It's an end time lesson. What's going to transpire? Joel 3, let's start at verse 1.
Joel 3, verse 1. For behold, in those days, and in that time, when I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem.
Meaning when the Lord returns us to our holy land, returns us to our right state of mind. Because we are the captivity. That's what it means, bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem. Go ahead.
I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat.
The valley of Jehoshaphat is a valley in the Middle East. Go ahead.
And will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel.
And when the Most High pleads with people, he don't plead by talking. Talking days in this verse right here, when this comes to pass, the pleading is no longer read descriptions. Give me that in Isaiah 66:15 about pleading.
Yeah.
This is how God pleads with nations. It's Isaiah 66:15.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 66, verse 15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire, and with his chariots like a whirlwind.
His chariots like a whirlwind, because those are the so-called UFOs. The chariots like a whirlwind, because they spin when they come. Go ahead. Read it again.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire, and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury, and his rebuke with flames of fire.
See that? See the pleading? Go ahead.
For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh.
So God pleads with fire and sword, meaning war. That's how he pleads. It's no, oh, Mr. Chinese man or Mr. Edomite man, let me talk to you. No. The Most High said, I'm going to plead with them now. With fire and sword. Read verse 16 again.
For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many.
God's going to kill a lot of people. The Lord Christ going to kill a lot of people. Let's go back to Joel 3 now. Now we understand that plea.
Joel 3 verse 2. I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat, and will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel.
So the pleading that God's doing with the nations is for our behalf. You got a lot of people marching, picketing for no war. Are you dumb? We want the wars to take place. Because God's pleading with the nations on our behalf. He says, I'm going to get you back into your homeland. I'm going to restore everything y'all lost. But our people are picketing against that thing. Picketing. Can you imagine that? God says, I'm going to give you riches. Oh, I don't want it, Lord. I like being a coon here in America. No, I don't like being that here in America. I want my riches, my fame, my fortunes. I want my language, my nationality. I want it all back. And I want servants.
I want my woman back.
I want my women back. Where are my women? Read that again.
I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat, and will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land.
Because, so now the Lord's explaining, in case you don't know who Israel is, because there's a lot of debate, who is Israel? 1948, what happened, Malachi? What happened in 1948?
So, Amalek going to the Middle East, and they are Israel.
Right, the League of Nations set up the white man in our homeland as the Israelis. Okay, then you had another Edomite named Eleazar ben Yehuda, who taught everybody that came back they had to learn Yiddish. They had to learn it. That put on the air, that put on the, what's the word? The fraud that they're the people of God. So everybody's going, oh, look, the Jews are back, and look, they even speak Hebrew. That's what, it was a whole conspiracy. Give me that in Isaiah 66, you know what I want? About the controversy.
Yes.
Of Zion.
It's the book of Isaiah, chapter 34 and verse 8. For it is the day of the Lord's vengeance.
Now this day is the same day we're reading about in Joel 3 and 2.
For it is the day of the Lord's vengeance and the year of recompenses for the controversy of Zion.
Y'all see that? For the controversy of Zion. Because there's a controversy. Who is Zion? Where are the 12 tribes of Israel at? Because according to the so-called white man, that group that's in there claims that they're Judah. They're not Judah. So there's a controversy. Let's go back to Joel 3 and 2 again. I want to read that whole verse.
Joel 3 verse 2. I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat and will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land.
So in case you didn't know who Israel was, the Lord gives you an example. He says, whom they have scattered among the nations. Now you got to examine who was scattered amongst the nations and how. By Deuteronomy 28:68. The Lord shall send thee into Egypt again with ships. Read that again.
I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat and will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land.
Now he says, and parted my land. Give me a verse for that. And parted my land. Where would you go?
Ezekiel 36 verse 5.
Ezekiel 36 verse 5. I like that. Read that for me, y'all. Sup? That explains and parted my land. That is another one. We want, but let's read this one first.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 36 and verse 5. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, surely in the fire of my jealousy have I spoken against the residue of the heathen and against all Idumea.
Idumea is a Greek word for what, Kazakh?
Edom.
Edom, go ahead.
Which have appointed my land into their possession.
Boom, that's the proof right there. Which have appointed themselves, appointed my land into their possession. Go ahead.
With the joy of all their heart, with despiteful minds.
Evil minds. Despiteful because they set themselves up as the Jews. Go ahead.
To cast it out for a prey.
Right. Then they say, come to Israel. Come with friends. So now there's another scripture. I want a New Testament one. I'm Leon.
Luke 21, 24.
Let's get that one. Luke 21, 24. Y'all son, you got that?
It's the book of St. Luke 21, 24. And they shall fall by the edge of the sword.
The Israelites shall fall by the edge of the sword.
And shall be led away captive into all nations.
And shall be led away captive into all nations. Let's see who's thinking. Where did we just read that at? Kazakh.
Deuteronomy 28.
No, we didn't read that. It's Ezekiel.
Joel 3.
Joel 3. And scattered my people. Did y'all forget that? That's why we're going to these precepts. Go ahead.
And shall be led away captive into all nations, and Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles.
So that part, Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles. What is that precept with, Kazakh?
Joel 3, verse 2.
What part?
Israel scattered. Oh, no. Parted my land.
Right. And parted my land. Okay, everybody see that? Let's go back to Joel 3.
Joel 3,
the bottom of verse 2.
Mm-hmm. Joel 3, verse 2. Whom they have scattered among the nations.
Because we went into slavery on slave ships, right?
And parted my land.
The land was parted between the Israeli, so-called white man who calls himself Israeli, and who else?
Palestinians.
The Palestinian, the Arabs. Parted the land. That's why it's all that fighting over there. Okay? Read on.
Verse 3. And they have cast lots for my people.
And in case you're still confused about who the Jews are, The Lord says, I'm going to give you more details because of this controversy. Read that again.
And they have cast lots for my people.
Nigga, they get a soul to Master Charles in Virginia. That's casting lots. Bids. They bid for us.
And have given a boy for an harlot.
They made boys into breeders.
And sold a girl for wine.
They sold the young girls for wine. So in all the history books, go ahead.
That they might drink.
That they might party because they was raping the women of Zion. Let's go to Revelation 16 and 12.
Revelation 16, verse 12. And the sixth angel poured out his vial upon the great river Euphrates, and the water thereof was dried up.
So, this sixth seal is the seal that we're under. Where the river Euphrates, if any of you have been watching the news, I'm pretty sure a lot of you only watch Channel 7. You do yourself a disservice. You need to look at other news reports, especially out of America. Reports outside of America. All of American news media is censored. That's the word. Thank you. Censored. They hide a lot of things from you, like the fact that the Euphrates River is drying up. Okay? And that's what we're reading about here. So if you decide you want to be illiterate and don't want to watch that news, you're always going to be lost. Read that again, verse 12.
Revelation 16, verse 12. And the sixth angel poured out his vial upon the great river Euphrates, and the water thereof was dried up.
And along the Euphrates, there are, what is that word? There are dams set up for the various nations that that river travels through. If they do decide to get an attitude, they can cut the river off. And it will be completely dry. Okay? So these are the things you want to be cognizant of, be aware of, for when you're reading this. Remember, the scripture says watch as well as pray. Revelation 16 and 12.
And the sixth angel poured out his vial upon the great river Euphrates, and the water thereof was dried up, that the way of the kings of the east might be prepared.
So what John is explaining in the sixth seal is what we are reading about. What we read about in Joel 3, in verse 2, where the Lord said his determination is to gather the nations, okay, in the valley of Jehoshaphat. Come on.
And I saw three unclean spirits, like frogs, come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet.
Now, to understand, I'm talking to you captains now. To understand what these three frogs are, what must we first do? Read it again for me.
And I saw three unclean spirits, like frogs, come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet.
What must we determine? Remind.
Identify the dragon. Identify the beast and the false
You must identify, correct, you must identify who the dragon is. You must then identify who the beast is. Then you must identify the false prophet. If you don't do those three things, you're going to be lost in the sauce as to what those three frogs are. So notice, read it again.
And I saw three unclean spirits, like frogs, come out of the mouth.
Stop. It's coming out of the mouth of those three things. I'm not going to get too deep with y'all today, but this is why we need a captain's class. Okay? Real quick, I'm going to give you hints. I'm not going to go into detail. It's for y'all to do the research. And I'll leave it like that with that. Revelation 12 and 1, please.
Revelation 12, 3. And there appeared another wonder in heaven. And behold, a great red dragon, having seven heads and ten horns. And seven crowns upon his heads.
You stay in Revelation 16. Now stop. I need you read Revelation 16 to 12 again. Then I'm going to have Yahusab read his.
Revelation 16, verse 13.
13, I'm sorry.
Verse 13. And I saw three unclean spirits, like frogs, come out of the mouth of the dragon.
Stop. We want to identify the dragon. Revelation 12 and 3.
This book, Revelation chapter 12, verse 3. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon.
Why is this dragon red, Kazak? Why did it say blue? Why did it say black? Why is it stipulating red?
He's the red dragon in Genesis 25, 25, Esau.
Right, Esau, very good. Go ahead, Yahusab.
And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns upon his head.
Now, that's during the time of Christ, but Revelation 16 is going in future text. Now 13:1, we're still dealing with the dragon. Revelation 13:1.
And I stood upon the sand of the sea and saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having 7 heads and 10 horns.
It's the same dragon in Revelation 12:1. Go ahead.
And upon his horns, 10 crowns. And upon his heads, the name of blasphemy.
Now, this dragon, which we know now is red, it said, remember it said an unclean spirit like a frog came out of his mouth. Jump down, stay where you at. Revelation 13:6.
And he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God.
This is the frog. Remember it said an unclean spirit like a frog came out of the mouth of the dragon. What came out of his mouth is here in verse 6. Read it again.
And he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle and them that dwell in heaven.
So this dragon, red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns represents what, Liam?
Represents the white man.
The entire white race thought. Give me those 7 heads.
7 heads is Greece, Rome.
Greece.
Rome.
Rome.
Spain.
Spain.
France.
France.
Germany.
Germany.
Russia and Great Britain.
Russia and Great Britain. Very good. The 10 horns, what are they?
That's the 10 common markets.
Also NATO. Called NATO, right, or the European Union. Go back to Revelation 16 and 13 again.
Revelation 16:13. And I saw 3 unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon. And out of the mouth of the beast.
And out of the mouth of the beast. Go back to Revelation 13 again. And verse 11.
Revelation chapter 13, verse 11. And I beheld another beast.
Another what?
Another beast.
What did you read here in Revelation 16, 13?
And out of the mouth of the beast.
And out of the mouth of the beast. So the answers are here. Read.
And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had 2 horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon.
He had 2 horns like a lamb. That's their politics. Democracy and republicanism. It's a 2-horn system, okay? Now when you read down, go back to Revelation 16 again.
And I saw 3 unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet.
Now you want to know who the false prophet is. Go back to Revelation 13.
Revelation 13, verse 14. And deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles.
Now those miracles, jump up to 13 so we can see what those miracles are.
And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men.
The fire that comes down from heaven is what, Aymar?
The nuclear destruction.
Nuclear missiles, ICBM missiles, atom bomb.
And deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image.
The image that we're reading about is the false prophet that we're reading about in Revelation 16. Go ahead.
That they should make an image to the beast which had a wound by a sword and did live.
Go ahead.
And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast.
Whose life did they give to that image, Ezekiel?
They gave Caesar Borgia.
Whose life did they give that image? They gave that image, which the image is Caesar Borgia. They gave him the life of Christ. Go ahead, y'all, stop.
And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak.
Should what?
should both speak.
Remember we read in Revelation 16. Read that again, Eitan.
Revelation 16, verse 13. And out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet.
And out of the mouth of the false prophet. Read that again, Yahusha.
That the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed.
Okay, let's go back to Revelation 16. Now, when we finally do get the captain's classes, we will go in great detail, but not today. Now you captains have your homework to do. You have to learn to sit down, research, and study. Eitan, verse 14.
Mm-hmm. Revelation 16, verse 14. For they are the spirits of devils.
So the three things that's coming out of their mouths are the spirits of devils. You got democracy, republicanism, okay? You got Christianity, okay? Go ahead.
For they are the spirits of devils, working miracles, which go forth unto the kings of the earth.
And those three spirits go forth to all the kings of the earth. Go ahead.
And of the whole world, to gather them to the battle of that great day of God Almighty. Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watcheth.
Blessed is he that watcheth. You watch with the scriptures and what's going on in your surroundings, going on in the news. That's how you watch. Go ahead.
And keepeth his garments, lest he walk naked and they see his shame.
What does that part mean? And keep his garments, lest he walk naked and they see his shame. Leon.
But it says, in keeping his garments, meaning he keeps the commandments. And lest he walk naked, meaning sin. When you read Exodus 32 about Aaron, he made the people naked unto their shame.
Let's go to that. Exodus. Go to Exodus 32.
Exodus 32, verse 25. And when Moses saw that the people were naked, for Aaron had made them naked unto their shame among their enemies.
That's what it means to be naked. Meaning you're in the midst of sin. That's what the Bible is referring to when it says you're naked. That's why even with Adam and Eve, when it talked about they were naked, it didn't mean they were butt naked. It meant they were in the midst of sin. Okay? Let's go back to Revelation 16 again.
Revelation 16, verse 15. Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watches.
What does it mean he comes as a thief? Joel, he comes as a thief.
Meaning he's going to come when nobody's aware of him coming.
Right. A thief don't let you know when he's coming. A thief comes unexpectedly. That's how Christ said he's going to come. But he gave us clues. That's why he said watch. Watch and pray. Read again, Eitan.
Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watches and keepeth his garments, lest he walk naked, and they see his shame.
Come on.
And he gathered them together into a place called in the Hebrew tongue, Armageddon.
So the place is called is Armageddon, okay? Which is going into the same thing we read in Joel, the third chapter, about the Valley of Jehoshaphat, which is a region in the Middle East around the Euphrates River. Okay, from there. Let's go to 2 Esdras 9 in the Apocrypha.
2 Esdras 9 verse 1. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself.
Measure the time diligently in itself. Where did we just read that one word? Ezekiel.
Watch.
Watch. Watch. Watch. Watch. Measure the time diligently. Come on.
He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs past, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world.
Read that again.
Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world.
Come on.
Then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning.
So these things were always happening. So don't be deceived and think, oh, this is something new. about earthquakes and uproars of the people. It says this has been happening from the beginning, but it's talking about it's going to escalate and come closer and closer together. This is the same thing. Give me that Matthew 24. Y'all, son, you get it? Matthew 24, where Christ said the same thing.
This is the book of St. Matthew chapter 24, verse 6. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled. For all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet.
Notice Christ said to the Israelites, y'all don't be troubled over these things. Don't be troubled. Now give me the one in Luke where it says men's hearts failing them for fear. I want that one. Because we as the people of God are not to be scared or worried about wars and rumors of war. Why, Liam? Why?
Because it's showing us that Christ is coming.
Yes, something else that we said. Ezekiel. Yeah, something else. Pardon.
That's the Most High pleading with the nations.
Right. He's going to plead with them for our salvation. We went over class yesterday. There's no salvation without what?
Destruction.
Destruction. Only he was paying attention. There's no salvation without destruction. Somebody got to be ransomed. Remember we read that in Isaiah before?
Luke 21, verse 25. And there shall be signs in the sun, and in the moon, and in the stars.
Here's the part.
And upon the earth, distress of nations.
Distress of nations. Do y'all see what's happening in Greece today with their monetary system? Nobody's watching?
Yes.
Who can explain it?
Their new government is collapsing. They elected a new government to try to stave off their, because they're in debt. There is so much debt that not even the whole European Union can help them. And it's affecting the whole world. Everything's being bad. But specifically over there, they said they're going to fall into a state of anarchy because their economic system is going to crash. They have no money.
Exactly. Y'all got to watch for things like that. Yeah.
And with the sanction that the United States put on Iran, that's also stressed their budget even further because they get most of their oil from Iran.
You see that?
They're scrambling to try to find another source for their oil, which is they can't do.
So that's an example of they're watching. These brothers are watching. Okay, I thought, read that again.
And there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars and upon the earth, distress of nations.
Distress of nations. Go ahead.
With perplexity.
With perplexity, meaning confusion.
Anarchy.
Anarchy. How did this happen to Greece? The cradle of civilization, as they say. It's almost civil war over there. Go ahead.
The sea and the waves roaring.
Come on.
Men's hearts failing them for fear.
See that? Men's hearts failing them for fear. That's why you got a lot of Edomites building underground bunkers. Oh, we got to prepare for the end times. 2012, December, whatever the date is they got.
That new one.
That new date that.
Last year was May.
Read that again.
For men's hearts failing them for fear and for looking after those things which are coming on the earth. For the powers of heaven shall be shaken.
Go ahead.
And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud.
Coming in a cloud. What is that cloud? The chariots, the so-called UFOs. Coming in a cloud. That's what we read in Isaiah 66, verse 15 and 16. Go ahead.
With power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass,
that's why they got all these movies about space invaders, aliens, battleship, all that.
Read that statement again, what you just read. With what? With power and what?
With power and great glory.
See, when the nations read this, they're reading about Christ coming back with glory. That glory is not for them.
That's right.
That glory is for the Israelites. I just heard the elder mention about a class that was taught yesterday is that salvation can't come without the destruction of the nations. So he's bringing glory to us, but he gonna slay everybody else.
That's right.
Okay, that's beautiful. That's music.
That is beautiful.
That's music. I like that thing.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Come on.
And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory.
Here come.
And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads. For your redemption draweth nigh.
You see what Christ said to us? We now start to see these things. Look up, for your redemption draws nigh.
For your redemption, not nobody else's.
That's right.
Everybody else's, that's a day of sadness and grief.
That's why they're picketing and marching, trying to prevent wars. We're not trying to prevent nothing. We want it to go down, because the Lord told us, look up, for your redemption draws nigh. Right. We supposed to, when I see the news and things pop off, I'm like, praise the Lord! Right. Kids, come in new, come look at the news! That's how you gotta get your mind fixed like that. Don't be home crying. Oh Lord, hundreds of people died.
Right. You know how you know that's true? I had some Edomites at my job. There was this trivial discussion going on. And they were asking the other Edomites, did you see this that happened in the news? And I used to hear this as a kid, but now I understand it. They say, I don't watch the news because it's depressing.
Yeah.
Y'all ever heard that?
Yeah.
People say, I don't watch the news because it's depressing. And I thought something was wrong with me because I'm flipping through 9 channels. I'm excited. But to them, it's depressing.
Right.
And a Negro like to say that too, so watch those also.
Right. The Negro said it because they don't know.
Yeah.
That is for their salvation. The Lord's coming to save our people, and Negroes are upset. That's a coon for you right there.
100%.
Come on.
And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby ye have believed.
Read verse 7 again.
And everyone that shall be saved.
And everyone, man and woman of Israel,
that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works.
By his works. By his works, and what else?
And by faith.
And by faith. You need those two things. Okay?
Shall be preserved from the said perils, and shall see my salvation in my land, and within my borders. For I have sanctified them for me from the beginning.
So the Lord got spirits out there that he got sanctified for him from the beginning. From the beginning, you know what that means? We was with him in the beginning.
Amen.
He said, these souls, I'm going to sanctify you. You souls, you particular ones are going to be in the last days. But don't worry, I got you. That was already set up from the beginning, before Genesis 1 and 1.
Amen.
Now I just went over your head with that thing. Right there. I know you're like, huh? Huh? Okay, come on.
Verse 8, shall be preserved from the said perils, and shall see my salvation in my land, and within my borders. For I have sanctified them for me from the beginning.
From the beginning, from there. Let's go to 2 Esdras chapter 6. Let's back up to chapter 6 and 23.
2 Esdras 6 verse 23. And the trumpet shall give a sound.
And the trumpet shall give a sound.
Which when every man heareth, they shall suddenly be afraid.
They shall suddenly be afraid. Watch this.
At that time shall friends fight one against another, like enemies. And the earth shall stand in fear with those that dwell therein. The springs of the fountains shall stand still. And in 3 hours they shall not run.
Come on.
Whosoever remaineth from all these that I have told thee shall escape. And see my salvation and the end of your world.
Meaning Esau's world. That's what he's talking about. Go ahead.
And the men that are received shall see it, who have not tasted death from their birth.
So there's going to be certain spirits who will not taste death from their birth.